Friends, in this video I am going to show you how to make this type of LED strip at home. This LED strip has cost me rupees 20 to 25. This is 12 volt LED strip. It works when the current is in 1 ampere scale, 1 to 1.5 ampere scale. This works only in 12 volt DC supply, not in 12 volt AC. We require to convert the DC AC to AC signal to DC for working of any sort of LED. Friends, for this we require small type of this type of LED. We can even use any sort of LED, but we had to remove their terminals. But these are the button LED, and it had got its name because they are button shape, and I had used this type of ice cream stick to fix the LED there. This is serve as the base for fixing and heating. Each LED has near about 1 wattage value, or say there are 3 LED. Then we had to remove insulation at this point, again at this point, and again roughly at this point. This for this we don't require any sort of scale, just we remove a few centimeter of the insulation at both the end and in between as per our requirements. And then after doing this, this gives a complete LED. Friends, there is nothing else hidden circuit in this board. Just you can see the two terminals, and now I am going to make this LED glow in this circuit that I has made in my last video today only. This each LED have simply about 1 wattage value, and hence the 3 LED total makes 3 watt LED. This friends, we are going to solder the positive and negative terminals in parallel combination, and then we are going to connect the ends. Friends, this is just a sample. After soldering it, it looked like this. I had made a sample earlier. These are the same thing that I had made, and I had used this type of belt wire for connection, tearing this wire from separating these two wires, and then removing insulation after marking at regular intervals. Say there are 3 LED. Friends, you can see this LED is glowing after switching on the circuit, and I had some problem with this middle LED. This is not glowing, maybe some problem with the conduction. And this is the same switch that I had kept on. Friends, now this LED is workable and we can work with this LED. These are glowing fully. For this 4.5 volt to if we take 4 to 4.5 volt, 1.5 to 2 or 2 ampere current is enough for its maximum brightness, and we are not using any sort of heat sink here, so it may become warm after some time. And now I am going to switch off my room light, and again you can see these are brightly lit LED. And again I am going to switch my the lights on. Again the bright the room becomes much more brighter for the LED tube that I had on the background. So friends, with this tutorial you can easily make this type of small LED strip. This type of LED strip even works with your bike battery. You can fix this type of LED in your bike's silencer, cycle mudguard, or anywhere. These are rough and tough, and we know that this wood or the chopstick are waterproofable. You can, but for this you need a better quality gum, say Fevikwik or glue gun or waterproof dendrite for fixing joint, as bikes and vehicles, motor vehicles and cycles are exposed to extreme weather conditions, so they require quick fix type glue, rough and tough glue. And this even works with bike battery, and just we had to fix some resistance. as bike batteries uses 12 volt 7 ampere battery, but for 7 ampere the current is too much high. We need to use 1 kilo ohms resistance with series combination to the output terminal of this type of LED. Then just then it will work with bike battery, or else it will be damaged. So quite an easy, friends. And now I am going to decorate this LED with glitter. Friends, as you can see, I had connected both the terminals in same manner with this circuit, and with great carefulness I am going to switch on the switch with switch from the switchboard, and using the same screwdriver with great safety I am going to switch it on. Say there are three LED, then we had to remove insulation at this point, again at this point, and again roughly at this point. For this we don't require any sort of scale, just we remove a few centimeter of the insulation at both the end and in between as per our requirements. And then after doing this, this gives a complete LED. Friends, there is nothing else hidden circuit in this board, just you can see the two terminals. And now I am going to make this LED glow in this circuit that I has made in my last video today only.